In this vlog, let us try to continue with our Flutter hooks concept, and now we will try to see one more hook as a part of our Flutter hooks concept and how we will make use of it in our programming. So the name of the hook is like useValueChanged. Yes, by the name itself, you can recognize the functionality of this particular hook here. So whenever there is any change in the particular value, then it will try to make a callback and will try to implement a particular functionality which you have specified. For example, let us try to consider you have specified a variable, and whenever there is any update to that particular variable, then this particular useValueChanged will try to observe the change and will try to implement the functionality which you have specified. So I think this might not be clear for you on the first go. So let's try to move ahead into the tutorial, and by the end of this tutorial, I'm sure this will be a very much easy hook for you, just like we have seen the useContext hook previously. So yes, useValueChanged is also as easy as useContext. So if you have not gone through that particular tutorial, I'm providing the link here in the iCard. So now let's start with this particular tutorial and try to see more information about useValueChanged and also its implementation. So now let's try to see the syntax first. So here we go. This is the syntax which is available from official documentation. So now let's try to see. So the first thing it will do is like it will make you a callback whenever there is any change in the value which you have specified. So it will accept a value, and whenever there is any change to that particular value, it will try to implement the functionality which you have specified, and it will also provide you the old value and old result, which I will be showing you in the coming example here. So we will try to create a simple application where we try to make use of this particular useValueChanged hook and try to understand it much better. So let's start with the programming part. So this is just, I want to show you the syntax over here. If you are confused here, you will be getting clarified in the next section, that is programming, where I will try to demonstrate you with the implementation of this particular useValueChanged. So now let's get started. So in this vlog, we will try to demonstrate the implementation of useValueChanged hook. So I have previously added the dependency for this particular tutorial here. So Flutter hooks I have added. So if you are watching this tutorial for the first time, I am providing you the link in the description section below for the entire Flutter hooks series. So I suggest you to go through them to get a good knowledge on what are Flutter hooks and how we implement them. So now let's continue with this particular tutorial here on useValueChanged. So the very first thing we do is like we try to import material.dart here, and these are all the basic things I'm covering, just targeting the beginners. So if you are well aware of all these things, you can just directly skip into the content. And so the next import is like, let us try to import Flutter hooks.dart here, and let us specify void main, and here within this let us try to specify run app here, and inside which let us try to specify our default class my app. So now let us try to specify a stateless widget my app here. And so here we have just created the basic structure, and now we'll try to return a material app instead of a container here. So let us try to return a material app here, and inside the home let us try to return a scaffold now. And inside the scaffold we will try to make use of an app bar and body here. So this scaffold will form a skeleton for your application. So let us try to specify app bar here, and here let us try to specify the title with the help of a text widget. So here I'm just specifying hooks here as a title. So inside the body here I'm going to create one more class here, and which will I will be naming it as home. So now let's try to create another class with a stateless widget here, home. And now I will try to rename the stateless widget to hook widget here. So this is how I do this, basically to make it much easy for you to understand here. So we are now having a class home which is extending hook widget over here. So here we have got a class home which is extending a hook widget here, and now we are trying to return a container. So instead of a container, let us try to specify column here, and inside the column I'm going to specify children, and the first thing I'm going to specify is like a text widget. So with the help of this text widget, we will be trying to display some information which we are trying to change. And the next thing I'm going to specify is text button here, and with the help of this particular text button, we are going to make a change. So on press, and also here let us try to specify a name here. So with the help of a text widget, I'm going to specify increment, or just for easy to understand, update. So I'm going to specify the name like update here for our button. And now within the hook widget here, we are having this particular widget build. So inside the build method, we need to specify our hooks here. So inside the build method, we need to specify our hooks. So you should not specify before the build method here, because that won't be recognized. So now let us specify a variable final count equal to useState here. So I'm going to make use of useState here. I have clearly explained about the useState hook concept here in this particular tutorial. So I'm providing the link in the description section. Also try to go through that particular tutorial if you are having any queries on this particular useState here. So again, I'm going to specify one more variable, and that is to be updated count here. So this is the updated count value. And yes, now we have specified two variables here, like count and updated count, and we are making use of useState here. And why we are making use of useState, I have clearly explained in the useState tutorial. So do visit that particular tutorial if you are having any queries. And now let us try to make use of our actual concept, that is useValueChanged here. So useValueChanged. Try to follow the syntax exactly here. The first thing we are going to make use here is like our value. So we have seen the syntax before, right? So the first thing you need to specify here is like value. So what is the value we are having here? So it is a count variable, and as we are making use of useState here, it's a value notifier. So you need to make use of value here, dot value, count dot value. You need to specify whenever you are trying to make use of the value, you need to specify count dot value, and whenever you are trying to update also, you need to make use dot value, because it's a dot value notifier here. And the second thing is like a function which will have old value and old result here. And here I'm just specifying this according to the syntax, and you can just specify anything like a comma b also here. So just to follow the syntax, and whenever you see the documentation, you should not get confused, right? So there it's like old value, old result. So just basically targeting for beginners, and for experience they might have already known this particular thing. So within this, now we are going to return. So now let us try to return updated count dot value equal to updated count dot value plus 2 here. I will try to add plus 2 this particular variable every time. So don't get confused why we are making use of dot value here. So I hope you are already knowing this particular thing. We have detailedly discussed in useState here. So we are trying to fetch the value updated count dot value, and we are going to add plus 2 for it. Now let's come back to our text here, text widget here. So now let's try to specify updated count dot value here. Make sure here we will be trying to update the first variable, which is count here, and we are trying to display the second variable updated count here. So now let's try to update count dot value plus plus here. So if you are having any confusion, I will try to provide you the summary once again here now. So with the help of a text button, we are trying to increment this particular variable value here. So count.value plus plus. And now whenever there is any change in this particular variable count dot, whenever there is any change in this particular variable count, then our use value change will get notified and it will try to return a callback here. So the callback will increment updated count dot value plus 2 here. So every time you tap on the particular button, plus 2 will be incremented, and this particular updated count is being displayed with the help of a text widget here. So I hope you are very much clear till now, and now let us try to run this particular code and see the output once. So here we go, our application is now able to see in the simulator here. So I have just made it to the top left here, so you can just update it to the center of the screen here. And whenever I tap on this particular update button here, you can see 2 is being specified here, and whenever I tap again, it's been 4, 6, 8, because we are every time trying to add plus 2 here. And now let us also try to see what is old value and old result here. So you might be getting a doubt like what these two things will have. So let us try to see by printing them. So add a dollar symbol before the object here. So old value, and try to specify some. So I'm just trying to specify 2 hyphens in between to just make sure you find some gap in between them, and old result here. And now let's try to see here. Here you can see. And one more thing, if you have noticed, I have not tapped on any of these buttons here, and I have not even tapped on control save here. So just I return the code here and try to observe the change. And in this span of time, our code is being updated, compiled, and the new output here you can see is being printed here. This is how our Flutter application is much faster in compiling and providing the output here compared to our native applications. And you might be confused, here we are getting 5 and 10. So now let us try to run from the beginning so that you will get a good clarity here. So here you can see our counter is now 0 here. And whenever we tap on this particular update button here, you can see first time we have got 0 and null here. And when you tap on this again, you'll be getting 1 and 2. So what is 2 here? So let us consider this is a serial number like 0, 1, 2. But that's not a serial number here. So what is that? Is like your count here. The 0, 1 it is specifying, right? So we have specified initially 0. So 0 is being printed here. And as we have incremented it, we have incremented it plus plus. I mean, we have not specified like 2 or 3 anything. So whenever you specify like this, it will increment by 1 here. So the second time it's been incremented, and the count variable is being printed here. So the first value which is being printed is always a count variable, and the second value which is being printed is the old result here. So for example, let us consider here we are having 4, and whenever you tap on this particular update button here, try to observe here. Whenever you tap on this particular update button here, you can see we have got 4 here. So what is 4? 4 is our previous result. And what is 2? 2 is our old value, that is the count variable here. So every time the count variable is being printed, next time 3 will be printed and 6. So 3-6 will be printed here. So here you can see this is what the old value and old result is containing. So I hope now you understood this particular tutorial and use this particular use value change according to your requirement here. So sometimes you will be having your own requirements for app specific requirements. For example, it's like a weather app or any other app where you are dependent on particular value and trying to change something on the screen, or you want to send a message or anything like that. So in this particular scenarios, you can easily make use of this particular use value change hook here. And if you are watching this tutorial for the first time, and we have covered few hooks concepts previously, and I have provided them in form of a playlist, and I'm providing it in the description section below, and I hope you watch it. So yes, this is it for this tutorial, and if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below, and the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. So yes, this is it for this tutorial on use value change, and I hope you understood this part of this tutorial, and hope you like this tutorial. So do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.